We want to solve the system of equations by graphing. To solve a system of equations, we want to determine the x and y values that satisfy both of the equations. To do this using the graphing method, we'll graph both lines on the same coordinate plane, and then we'll analyze the graph to determine the solution. Let's do a quick review of what can happen when you graph two lines on the same coordinate plane. Well, the first possibility we see here, where the two lines intersect, in this case we have one solution, which would be the coordinates of the point of intersection. This type of system is consistent and the equations are independent. We could also graph two lines that never intersect or they're parallel. In this case, there's no solution to the system, and the solution is called inconsistent and the equations are independent. And the last possibility is the two lines coincide or are on top of one another. In this case, we have an infinite number of solutions, and the system is consistent and the equations are dependent. Now let's take a look at our example. We want to graph both of these lines on the same coordinate plane. We can graph these lines any way that we want, but they are in sloped intercept form, or the form y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope of the line and b is the y-intercept of the line. So the first line has a slope of negative 2, the second line has a slope of negative 6, the first line has a y-intercept of positive 2, the second line has a y-intercept of negative 2. And we can use this information to graph our lines. Let's graph the first line in blue and the second line in red. So for the blue line, the slope is equal to negative 2, but we'll write that as negative 2 over 1. We always want the slope to be in fraction form, then the y-intercept would be positive 2. Remember, the slope is the ratio of the change of y to the change of x, or the ratio of the rise to the run. So we'll first plot the y-intercept at positive 2, and then since the slope is negative 2 over 1, we'll go down 2 units and write 1 unit to find more points on the line. Let's go ahead and do this again. Down 2, right 1, and now we'll sketch the line. And now for the second line, a red line, we have a slope of negative 6, or negative 6 over 1, and a y-intercept of negative 2. So we'll plot the y-intercept. But then notice if we go down 6 units and write 1 unit, we'll be off the graph. So at this point, we can make a table of values or recognize that we can rewrite the slope as positive 6 over negative 1. Both of these would simplify to negative 6. And with the slope in this form, we can now go up 6 and left 1 instead of down 6 and right 1. Using either form of the slope, we'll find another point on the red line. So we'll go up 6 and left 1. Looks like we just found our point of intersection. Let's go ahead and sketch our red line. So this point of intersection represents the solution to the system, meaning the coordinates of this point would satisfy both equations, where the x-coordinate is negative 1 and the y-coordinate is positive 4. So we have one unique solution, which we can leave as an ordered pair, or we can write as x equals negative 1 and y equals positive 4. And because this system has a solution, we call it a consistent system. And because the equations are different, we say the equations are independent.